Well, we gave you a sneak peek. Now the boat that'll hopefully keep the America's Cup and New Zealand's Cup has formally been launched. Hundreds turning out for the early morning christening of Te Aihe, which means dolphin.
And just like its namesake, the boat looks fast and sleek and is already at the centre of global attention. That scrutiny also coming from a foreign rival who fessed up to One News. Nicole Bremner was at the big reveal.
From a sailing team with cutting edge in its DNA, there's palpable excitement over Te Aihe the dolphin and her potential impact on the 36th America's Cup.
Our team New Zealand and this project is right at the very top, along with Rocket Lab for innovation, incredible high tech and design.
Hundreds coming out early in the rain for an up close look at the boat, born out of more than 100,000 hours of hard work. With skills poured into high tech design and careful construction at the team's building yard just north of the city.
It's euphoric, you know, where we're at. There's nothing worse than a bunch of sailors walking around getting really angry and grumpy because they can't go yachting.
Among the many taking in all 6.5 tonnes of the AC-75, competitors who've travelled down under, especially for the unveiling.
You're here for Luna Rossa, so is it spying?
I don't know, it's part of the game. All the guys want to know, obviously, what the defender do.
This newbie, a radical departure from past defenders on the Waitemata.
Team New Zealand complete the first successful defence.
Keeping our Red Sox frenzy alive until the heartbreak that followed in 2003.
Team New Zealand broken their mast.
Now a feeling of quiet confidence for 2021.
I think it's beautiful.
He's talking about 50 knots.
We're very proud to be New Zealanders.
That'd be like flying. You'll have to have bloody safety belts on or something.
Are you going to miss the cyclores?
Yeah, well, obviously you have to power the boat some way.
But exactly how they'll do it this time remains a mystery.
Where's this all being sent back to?
Just to our base, our headquarters.
But the Kiwis seem used to all the attention.
Team New Zealand's the first syndicate to launch its race boat and set up camp at Auckland's Viaduct Basin. But work's continuing at pace here to make space for the other challenges. They'll start arriving here in the next few months.
Tonight, the new boat's out of the water but still centre stage and looking quite comfortable there. Nicole Bremner, One News.
All right, let's take a closer look now at the AC-75 class boat and what it can do. As the name suggests, it is 75 feet or 23 metres long, a monohull, unlike the last double-hulled America's Cup model. 26.5 metres, that's the height from the top of the rotating mast down to the deck, which will hold 11 crew members. Below deck, these arms on the side here, the 4-metre foils, will be identical features for all teams. Each foil arm has a wing attached to its tip, which can be custom built by each team. Now, these components are designed to make the boat fly up to 95 kilometres an hour. An electronic hydraulic system moves the foils in and out of the water. Controlling them helps with stability, lift and speed during racing. The most visible differences in each team's boats will be the hull shapes and the layout of the decks. And we'll have much more on Team New Zealand's new boat later in sport.